few thousand years, this neocortex, that is the upper part of the brain that is having a lot of neuron cell bodies, that has developed. Now, neocortex is very important for mathematical calculation, your effort thinking, your scientific temperament, your ingenuity or innovation part. So this way, okay, so this is the development of the brain, how neurophysiologically from lizard brain to mammalian brain to neocortex has developed. Now, by 1500 BCE or before that, there was little language conversation. So only humans were able to do the sign languages, and then storytelling or a word of mouth or experiential teaching was happening between the teacher and the students, or from parents to the son or daughter. This way, the information was the first attempt offloaded from one brain to the another, so that generation by generation, we can change or modify the memory. This way, and then around 1200 BC, it is said that Rig Veda was the very first script. Script writing started around that time, and later on, then Aristotle and Plato, these all Greek mythology. Even before that, Indic Vedic culture also having this script writing. So that is another sign. Other than storytelling, then we started having script writing and leaving it for the next generation to add upon or to utilize this memory part. And then from around 100 to 200 BC to till like 1860, that is being called as a so-called industrial revolution. In my opinion, that was the period of having emotional and social memory improvement. In that period, human population has rapidly increased in the number, and there was a horizontal transfer of human population at the various continents of the world. And then people were getting settled as much as possible far apart over the whole globe. And this way, we were making the family, we were having the war, we were having some kings. And this way all lead to the social and cognitive, emotional memory other than the word of mouth and script writing. Now, you might have come across, there was a first industrial revolution based on the coal engine formation. Then later on it was related to the electricity, and then around 1950s computer has come up, and then 1985 onwards internet was given to the public from the US, and then around 1996 in India it started. So now very rapidly, last 78 years since the development of the computers has again taken a part of the human memory as an offloading method, and it is another method of transferring the knowledge or someone's brain memory to the next generation. So, in that industrial area, we have a lot of procedural memory, I would say, in that around 200 or 300 years. We were making a lot of buildings, we were making even aeroplanes, bridges. So, that time there were a lot of development in the physical sciences, chemical sciences, earth sciences. We can say this all has happened like around 300 years or so. Then, okay, I must tell you the procedural memory. This is the easiest example. When a child is there, he learns how to tie the shoelace or how to do the bicycle. This all is procedural memory. So I mean that procedural memory of mechanistic, that motor function of the hands was more prominent than 300 years in that period. So we were making lot of paraphernalia, electronics items and this all. Then now, as in the age of computer, when we have a parallel computer system, there was CD, DVD or so initially, that time we have started having collective memory use. So you can think that I can write something, I can do my memory in one CD and I can transfer to someone else. Then one can also add upon some memory of his own brain or some cognitive function. And then we can keep changing and modifying time to time. So now you see this notorious internet is there, you know, because it's having demerits and demerits both. So then internet started. Internet is again a collective memory of so many humans. So now you can imagine, because internet is written by we all humans, so lot of people are putting their data, and it is easily accessible by anyone throughout the world by just one click of mouse away. But the problem is now we are having lot of information. There are billions and billions of web pages, billions and billions of data over Google, Wikipedia. But but it is someone's agility, what is correct, what is not correct. So now we are flooded with lot of things, you know, email or Wikipedia and lot of, you know, internet-based methods of collective memory that can be chosen by anyone in the world now and anyone can utilize it. Similarly, that is I started my talk about the cognitive offloading of human memory. So now this is the actual brain, then a healthy brain harness a healthy mind, and healthy mind has a good memory. But now memory, how it is getting offloaded or transferred or being having symbiotic relation between internet and the human brain. And so now we have lot of media, including Facebook, and you can imagine how we are utilizing the memory of memories for the next generation. So it is just again a perpetuation of memory, I can say. Like we all human are mortal, we can go one day. But our memories in the form of video, audio, our word is still there. So this way it is good way. And now, including from the very first, now the memory sources is not only script, not only the books, not only procedural memory, but it is through the mass media of the computer knowledge. Now, this new term has come up recently about digital amnesia or Google effect. Now, this Google or the immense use of the internet is affecting our human memory. Now, you might have seen, you know, many people who can do the simple arithmetic by just handwriting, but it is human tendency to recheck it by the computer or by using calculator in the mobile phone. It means we are getting more dependent on the computer for the function, and this way, this internet change are taken over our simple short-term memory, long-term memory. Now we are working only on the short-term memory basically. So, like if you want to extract some information now on a Google, today you can learn it, and within a few seconds you can change over to next. So it's like a hopping business on internet. We keep changing the pages. We keep changing information to information. Then again after 10 days or so happen that if you want to know the same information, then again you ask the same question to the internet. It means we are having only the short-term memory. If you write it down somewhere, if you make a diary or so, that time it makes long-term memory, because that time more than one senses are working together to consolidate that memory. But the internet memory or this flashing memory on the screen or computer or laptop, it's just a shorter memory, and we are living in that way. Now, this is having a lot of demerits. Now, even the schools are boasting to have an ICT, but there is again disadvantage that ICT is affecting the cognitive power of the students. It's in some way we are going away. But in the neurobiology, there is one word called neuroplasticity, or we used to say that brain is plastic in nature. So human brain is being made by the mother nature like that. It keep changing and keep adapting to the better and betterment time to time. So our brain is also being changing. It was initially like storytelling, I told you, then script writing, then processor memory. Now it is collective memory of the internet all around the world. And now two more new things are coming up. So where we are going by the brain by? So there are two things coming up, and research is already going in a small animals. It is brain to brain interface and brain to machine interface. Brain to brain interface is again controlling one brain and sharing the, you know, like a telepathy controlling the other person, and that happens. This way our brain is getting more manipulative in nature. And that is happening in some elections also. You can imagine a few of the elections where the mass public is being, you know, manipulated by media, and smart people take advantage of it. Similarly, brain to machine interface, where the human brain memory will be updated online over the internet time to time, and this way it will be having more manipulative or more getting hacked. So we should be very careful for the technology upcoming. Thank you so much.